Welcome to this morning service for Sunday, September 18, 2022, Proper 20, from the historic St. John's Cathedral. This morning's Holy Eucharist will be led by the Anglican Cathedral College. We pray that this service brings blessing and joy to you and your loved ones in your homes this morning. Thank you for joining us.
Lord of our hopefulness, Lord of our joy, whose trust ever childlike no cares could destroy. Be there at our waking and give us, we pray, your bliss in our hearts, Lord, at the break of the day. Lord of all eagerness, Lord of all faith, whose strong hands were skilled at the plane and the lathe. Be there at our labors and give us, we pray, your strength in our hearts, Lord, at the noon of the day. Lord of all kindliness, Lord of all grace, your hand swift to welcome, your arms to embrace. Be there at our homing and give us, we pray, your love in our hearts, Lord, at the eve of the day. Lord of all gentleness, Lord of all calm, whose voice is contentment, whose presence is balm, be there at our sleeping and give us, we pray, your peace in our hearts, Lord, at the end of the day.
When the Spirit comes, I shall send to you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father. He will bear witness to me, and you also are witnesses, because you have been with me from the beginning. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
And the blessed
be his kingdom, now and forever.
Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed Lord and Father, we have assembled in your name and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your world and your church. Grant that we, confessing our sins, may worthily offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice, and eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen. We call it for purity. Almighty God, to you our hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We worship you, we glorify you. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord of God, Lamb of God, who take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Who are seated at the right hand of the Father,
receive all prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
That we may live peaceful and quiet lives in our guidance and hope. This is good and pleasing to God our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. For there is one God and one mediator between God and mankind, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all people. This has now been witnessed to at the proper time, and for this purpose I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying, a true and faithful teacher of the Gentiles. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The gradual hymn, Women's Glory. Please stand.
Chapter beginning at the first verse. Glory to Christ our Savior. Jesus said to his disciples, there was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that this man was squandering his property. So he summoned him and said to him, what is this that I hear about you? Give me an account of your management, because you cannot be my manager any longer. Then the manager said to himself, what will I do now that my master is taking the position away from me? I am not strong enough to live, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do, so that when I am dismissed as manager, people may welcome me into their homes. So summoning his master's debtors, one by one, he asked the first, how much did you owe my master? He answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. He said to him, take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, and how much do you owe? He replied, 100 containers of wheat. He said to him, take your bill, and make it 80. And his master condemned this honest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes. Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much, and whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. If then you have not been faithful with the dishonest one, who will entrust to you the true riches? And if you have not been faithful with what belongs to another, who will give you what is their own? No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other.
you cannot serve God and wealth. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord.
Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much, and whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. I speak in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today in our gospel reading, Jesus gave us a parable about a dishonest manager, and how he distributed the gifts entrusted to him by his boss so that they can be multiplied into more. In this reading, the master is God, who gives us all both young and not so young, great talents, gifts and treasures in this life for us to use. The dishonest manager would be you and me, who possess these wonderful gifts and talents on earth, and the debt pair would be the resources put into our care as stewards by God. As young persons and students of this esteemed institution, there are many lessons we can learn from this parable, because in this parable it teaches us that over and over again, we can witness on social media or television international artists flaunting enormous wealth in order to give off an impression that they are rich. What Jesus was trying to bring across in this parable was that the only way Christianity will feel like it is real and effective is when we spend as much of our time and effort and talent and resources in making a difference to make our communities a better place, as much as we do for party and other worldly enjoyments. My friends, as the present and the future of this country, we must go out and make this known to those in authority who have access to wealth and resources if we want to live in a better Belize. We must make sure that we make our cry loud and clear, that the same way our authorities can use thousands of dollars to host and promote many social events, in the same way they can use these wealth in order to build better schools, to improve our education and health care in our country, and to create better opportunities for all those students who keep on graduating from our primary school, colleges and universities year after year. Many times it was documented in scripture about persons who have enormous wealth, how terrible they were because they used their wealth to oppress the poor. And they only get richer while the poor get poorer. But to Jesus, for persons who are wealthy, he did not dislike them. He only disliked the way they treated the poor. And he keep on telling them that they must use their wealth to help the poor instead of oppressing them by making them more poorer than before. Furthermore, in this gospel lesson in verses 10 and 11, it teaches us about responsibility. As young persons who are the present and future, it gives us the example of a person's way of fulfilling a small task, that if we complete every little task given to us by our parents, our teachers, and our guardians, that this will show our fitness and readiness to be entrusted with larger tasks and responsibilities. My friends, this is clearly true when it comes to earthly things. Those of us who return back to school know this very well, that we have to be promoted from a lower standard or a lower form level, where the work was much more easier, where the teacher was much more lenient. And when we pass and was promoted to the other form or the next standard, now we notice that the workload is much more greater than our previous classes, and our responsibilities to get our school work done is much more important and dependent on our advancement to higher promotion to meet graduation. In the same way on earth, God gave us certain gifts and talents and resources he loaned us in order to see how well we will use what does not belong to us in a positive way. In the fullness of time, when we meet God face to face, in the life to come, we will receive what is really and truly ours, depending on how we use the gifts on earth of which we are caretakers of. One important theme that this gospel reading left us all with is that we must make a decision to say that we will serve God or we will serve the world and all that comes with it. Many times we only remember God when times get tough, or when or someone we know and love is undying. But as soon as we get what we want from God, He is forgotten. Serving God can never become a part-time or a spare job. As youths, when we decide to serve God and represent Him, we must do so with all our youthfulness and every atom of energy that belongs to Him. As young modern-day disciples of Jesus Christ, we must use all our gifts and talents and treasures to advance God's kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven. And not to advance our own little kingdom here on earth amongst our friends and peers or on social media for fame and likes. If you notice, the dishonest manager was shrewd. Some would say that he was wise to have made certain deals to save himself. Likewise, we too must be wise and use our gifts and talents and resources to build God's kingdom among us and to save ourselves and our future. The only way we can do this, my friends, is if we use these gifts and talents that we are hoarding for ourselves to make God trending and relevant, just like how the world makes parties and secular events look appealing to the eyes. We must learn how to use our master's resources to build his kingdom, so that when we arrive in front of him face to face, he will say to us, "Well done, good and trustworthy servant. You have been in charge of a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He'll come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, with the Father and the Son. He is worshipped and glorified, he has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. 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 Amen.
The prayers of the people, with all our heart and all our might, let us pray the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the peace from above, for the loving kindness of God, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord, Lord, have mercy. For the peace and welfare of the world, for the witness and work of the church, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord, Lord, have mercy. For our bishop, Bishop Philip Wright, and all ministers of God's word and sacraments, that they may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault at the Lord's coming. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For leaders of the nations, especially our Prime Minister, Honorable John Bisenya, and for those in authority among us, that they may serve justice and promote freedom and dignity of all people. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression, and for all who labor in the cause of human liberation and fulfillment, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the sick, especially those suffering from coronavirus or monkeypox, for the suffering, the sorrowful, and the dying, and for all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For deliverance from the ravages of earthquakes, drought, or flood, and for a just and proper use of God's creation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Give to all the faithfully departed eternal rest, especially Her Majesty, Queen Elizabeth II, by the grace of God, of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, Head of Commonwealth, with all our other realms and churches and defender of our faith, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all young people in the Anglican Diocese of Belize, and for our esteemed institution, the Anglican Cathedral College, we pray for its board, governors, administration, teachers, and students. We pray for all young persons in the country of Belize, in the province of the West Indies, and in the entire Anglican community worldwide, that they may be filled with the love of God and be courageous to be a light for the world, so they may shine and be an example for all to see. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For ourselves and all who confess the name of Christ, that we may show forth the excellences of Him who called us out of the darkness into His marvelous light, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people in the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion on us, all who turn to you for help, for you are gracious. O Lord of love, and to you we give glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
We lift up to God all those who seek the prayerful support of the Church. We continue to pray for God's protection and care during this hurricane season. We pray for those in the path of Storm Fiona. We pray for those who are ill and ask for God's healing grace to be upon them. Remember Father Mario Moreira, Wilmot Simmons, Doreen Young, Ismail Rekenya, William Hope, and Leroy Flowers, Bishop Lawrence Nicasio, Norma, Elizabeth Gentle, Estella Garbutt, and all our homebound sisters and brothers. We pray for those who have died recently. May their souls rest in peace, and may God's spirit of comfort and strength be with their families at this time. Whatever may be your need, know that God's loving presence and grace are sufficient to see you through. To God be the glory, great things He has done. Amen.
The act of penitence can be found on page 123 in the Book of Common Prayer. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins using faith. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, here, forgive us all of his faults, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The greeting of peace is Form 8 on page 123. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit.
Let us then pursue the things that make for peace, and build up the common life.
The peace of the Lord be always with you,
and also with you.
Let us share the peace in our homes with the person next to us.
Perfect harmony. Let begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternity. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
As we prepare to receive the offering today, we take this opportunity to give thanks to you for your ongoing support of the Anglican Diocese of Belize with your prayers and contributions. Thanks to your support, we're able to continue with this good work that God has called us to do in this part of His vineyard. You can make your contributions to any of our accounts. Firstly, for the Belize Bank, our account numbers are 129-806-010-120-001 or 2363-7601-0120-025. Or you can pay using your eCash digital wallet via phone or tablet by scanning the QR code on your screen or clicking the link provided. You can also use our accounts at Atlantic Bank, account number 21064301, or at the M&T Bank, number 1 Fountain Plaza, Buffalo, New York, account number 1569804. Once again, thank you very much for your support, and may God continue to bless you and your family.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due His name. Bring offerings and come into His courts.
The offertory hymn from the CPWI, hymn number 25, Pass It Forth.
It only takes us one to get a fire going, and soon all those around can warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with us. Once you experience it, you spread His love to everyone. You want to pass it on,
pass it on, pass it on.
What a wondrous time in spring, when all the trees are budding,
budding,
and birds begin to sing.
Stars, they're blooming, blooming. That's how it is with God's love. Once you experience it,
you want to see.
It's fresh like spring.
I want to pass it on, pass it on, pass it on.
I wish for you, my friend, that I have found, you can depend on Him.
It matters not where you are bound,
I shouted from the mountain top, praise love, I want the world to know,
the love of God has come to me, I want.
Pass pass it on, pass it on.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy
of the earth and the work of human hands, they will become our spiritual food.
All things come from you, O Lord, and of your own do we give you.
Blessed be God forever. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
to give God thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. Through Jesus Christ, because on this most glorious day, a triple light was given. On the first day of creation, you brought light and life into being. On the first day of our salvation, you raised your Son victorious over death. And on this day, you gave your Holy and life-giving Spirit to your church. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this song to proclaim the glory of your name. Out of death into life. Throughout the night, he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for remembrance of me. And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks to you, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for remembrance of me. Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer you our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit on these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things to Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of life, where you dwell with all your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Our Father,
those who are called to suffer of the Lord. Draw near and receive the body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ with faith and thanksgiving. We do not presume to come to this your table, most merciful Father, trusting in our own righteousness, but only in your boundless mercy. We are not even worthy to gather the crumbs on your table, but you are the Lord, ever the same, ever merciful. Grant therefore, Lord of grace and love, that we may so eat the flesh of your dear Son Jesus Christ and drink his blood, that with bodies and souls may clean from every stain of sin, we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. The body of Christ given for you. Blood of Christ shed for you.
Let us break bread together on our knees.
On our knees.
Let us break bread together on our knees.
On our knees.
When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, O Lord, have mercy on me. Let us drink wine together on our knees.
On our knees.
Let us drink wine together on our knees.
On our knees.
When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, O Lord, have mercy on me. Let us praise God together on our knees.
On our knees.
Let us praise God together on our knees.
On our knees.
When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, O Lord, have mercy on me.
Mercy on me.
Let us break bread together, we are one.
We are one.
Let us break bread together, we are one.
We are
one as we stand with our face to the rising sun. O Lord, have
mercy on us.
Let us drink wine together, we are one.
We are one.
Let us drink wine together, we are one. We are one as we stand with our face to the rising sun. O Lord, have mercy on us. Let us praise God together, we are one.
We are one.
Let us praise God together, we are one.
We are one.
We are one as we stand with our face to the rising sun. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Mercy on us.
Also, in the prayer can be found on page 148, the last prayer on that page. The Lord be with you.
And also
with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us all to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. At this time, we now have a special item by Mr. Ian Young, teacher at the Anglican Cathedral College.
I learned how Christian long ago before a tired soul, and they were told that he spared a life in the wilderness, a name of Christ. son of God, they will not deny, like a great angelic choir sing, I could almost hear their voices ring, I pledge allegiance to the Lamb, with all I am, with all I am, I will seek to honor His command. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb. Years is gone, and years is gone, but the cause of Jesus still goes on. Now the time has come to count the cost, to reject this world, to embrace the wrong. Let us live a life, Son who died to give us life, till the trumpet sound on His founding. Let us proudly say and boldly say, I pledge allegiance to the Lamb. With all my strength, with all I am, I will seek to honor His command. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb, to the Lamb of God, who bore my pain, who took my place, of my shame, see to honor commands, and I pledge allegiance to man.
You got to remember that it wasn't always this way.
Greetings and blessings from the Anglican Cathedral College. Join me as we present to you all the new improvements and the plans for the future.
As we embark on a new year, central to our mission is the building of a community of learners, where we strive to provide a physical, emotional, and cognitive environment that is conducive to the development and learning for each child that enters our doors. This strong commitment to their wholesome development requires a quality support program. Under the leadership of Ms. Janine Longsworth, who is our Student Support Vice Principal, ensures that the psychosocial and economic needs of our students are met on a daily basis. We believe that at ACC we have a committed team that comprises of our Board of Governors, which is chaired by Mr. Jeffrey Locke, our administration, myself, Mr. Nelson Longsworth, as the principal, and our academic vice principal, Ms. Rowena Pascasio, our HODs, and a vibrant teaching staff, our support personnel, including our ladies at the school's canteen, make ACC a safe and a special place for all. As we always say, ACC, a great place to learn.
The vision of the Anglican Cathedral College is to strive to being the best high school in the country of Belize. For achieving this, we hold firm to our motto, Nisi Dominus Fostra, which translates to, without God's help, we labor in vain. Being the only Anglican secondary school in the country, we hold close and dear to our existence is our devotion to our faith in Christ, our Lord. Our weekly church services and overarching religious curriculum embodies and encapsulates our students' spirituality, developing in them strong morals and values, which lays a solid Christian foundation. As we came back from the start of the new school year on August 22, 2022, there were a lot of excitement. COVID had restricted face-to-face engagement for more than 2 years, and classrooms are now filled with students. This excitement spilled over to even our teachers as they themselves were getting weary of online instruction. The campus came alive. This, of course, brought some challenges. Behavioral problems have been increasing, and the learning gaps created due to COVID are now being revealed. Confronting these challenges has been at the forefront of our attack. And in addition, this new year brings new curriculum changes as directed by the Ministry of Education. So we see hard and long days ahead, but we are resilient and capable. We must together overcome for our children. Students learning life skills and other cross-curricular skills have more than ever come alive this new year. Clubs are now up and running where students are engaged in playing chess, they're sewing and doing embroidery, they're practicing cooking, they're engaged in drama and creative arts, and those are just to name a few. And of course, a huge favorite is the school's band, both boys and girls practicing for the upcoming parades. There is without a doubt, the campus is very much alive. With the 2021 school year, we have been implementing the school's four-year school improvement plan. This plan seeks to significantly improve students' academic performance, their student support, human resource performance and management, and overall school governance. This year, we continue on our quest guided by this plan. You can see from the diagram, we have made some progress. Academic support systems have been put in place. We have increased our response to supporting students in need, and we have been making great strides in improving the working conditions of our teachers. And of course, the improvement continues. As you hear in the evening, the drums beating and the band practicing, ACC continues to march on. As a community, we are committed to the improvement process. We have some dedicated partners helping us to improve the quality of the programs we offer. Very fruitful examples are the Friends supporting the Anglican Diocese of Belize and Restore Belize. They have been providing unwavering support, and of course, the Ministry of Education that helps to enable ACC to carry out its mission. And of course, a very important partner is our parents. This partnership is what ensures that our students receive the best education that they can. I must say that the partnership with our parents is on the rise. We now have a vibrant PTA executive in operation, and we are committed to support the school in achieving its goals. The picture clearly shows the voting that was done, and that the picture then demonstrates the executive. We are looking forward for the executive and the PTA to continue supporting the education of their kids. Everywhere you turn at ACC, there are activities and programs that make us a special institution. We are piloting the infusion of a media literacy component into the curricula with the support of Dr. Bob and the U.S. Embassy. Currently, teachers are engaged weekly in training to learn how to deliver the new competency-based curriculum. And of course, the most special of all is the care and love we have for our children. We embrace them as family, and we go to great lengths to meeting their needs and provide the best we can for them. We continue to improve and deliver a quality education to our students. We know we cannot do it alone. We need as much help that we can muster. We need committed mentors. We need support for student learning devices. We need more scholarships for our needy students. We need more patrons for our fundraisers. We need you. We need you to join hands with us. So call us, email us, or just drop in. In the name of our Lord Jesus and Savior, we thank you.
Birthday greetings this week go out to Lilith Soberanus, Michael Arters, Karen Simplis, Judith Peterson, Reverend Elizabeth Blunt, John Moody, Rhonda Crichton, Saul Yam, Pauline Sylvester, Lissel York, Glenda Leben, Ella Pilgrim, Tintaichi Bishop, Nicole English, Ian Williams, Tyrell O'Brien, Bernard Young, Denzel Charles, Denise Greenwich, Matthew Comina, Clarice Williams, Michelle Moore, Mark St. John, Dale Rudder, Celia Benjamin, Robert Pate, Carla Gentle, and Marsha Hingson. May God continue to richly bless and keep each and every one of you. Congratulations go out to Reverend Father Rudolph Dawson, who was ordained priest, and Reverend Miss Rose Madeira, ordained deacon. We pray for their ministry, for God's continued guidance and blessing on what they do in His name and for His people. We want to acknowledge this week the anniversary of the passing of Percival Paul Beverly. So we continue to pray for the repose of his soul and also for God's spirit of comfort to continue to abide with his family. We want to, of course, thank God for his generous love and grace, helping us to do what we do and making this service possible. We also thank all those who participated in the service, who read lessons, shared the prayers. We want you to continue to pray for Hispanic ministry as it continues to develop and expand. We also thank those who provided the music and singing, the Diocesan Online Music Team, Mrs. Yvonne Sweet and the Sweet Chorale, and also the Diocesan Online Team for their continued support. Special thanks to Love FM Radio and Television for broadcasting our service. May God continue to richly bless each and every one of you. Now, if you'd like to participate in our service, share a notice, birthday, or anniversary greeting, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us. You can call us at 501-227-3029. That's 501-227-3029. Or 501-227-8055, 501-227-8055. You can also WhatsApp us at 501-626-1821, 501-626-1821. You can also email us at bzediocese@btl.net, bzediocese@btl.net. Now, of course, my friends, in this month of celebration, we want to take you and wish you a happy September celebrations. But remember, please be safe. Wear your mask, sanitize your hands, avoid crowds, even though that's going to be difficult this time of the year. But please be safe. And so we do want to wish you a blessed, safe, and productive.
And stand for the final blessing, the blessing of Pentecost. The Spirit of truth lead you into all truth. Give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and to proclaim the word and the works of God. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest on the man of God this day, now and forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen.